the Hindus will remain safe. Therefore, we must build a strong Hindu resistance, Hindu defense in every villages. There is no other way. The army cannot give protection. If you think the BJP government comes to Bengal and they will rescue Hindus, if army cannot give protection, the police, Bengal police will give protection, can give protection to the Hindus. Therefore, it is our duty in 1947, our forefathers, for their confusion of ideas, for their confusion of thinkings, they did not fight against partition. And now we are prepared to fight the coming partition. This is our determination. This is our pledge. And our leader, we hope a Hindu leader, not even like Modi. We want a Hindu leader like Abraham Lincoln to maintain their national integrity, who fought against his own countrymen. And that was civil war. And Hindus must give that taste that if really Hindus are the real owner of this land, Hindus have to establish the fact. And you know, all over the world, the legal things, the papers, the wills, etc., those do not give right to any land. Only might, only power gives that right. Therefore, Hindus have to show their might. Still now, the ownership of this land, the title suit of this land is undecided. Still now, Muslims love to believe that Britishers snatched their kingdom by deceit. Plassey war by Mirjafar, and Britishers deprived them. Still now, Muslims believe that when Britishers left in 1947, Britishers should have given the whole India to Muslim rulers. It is their belief. This is reality. In the below level, ground level Muslims, they spread this message. And this is true that in 1757, Britishers by deceit snatched their kingdom from Sirajuddin. Therefore, they now reclaim that. Particularly Bengal, Bihar, and Odisha, that was Sirajuddin's kingdom. In the eastern part of India, the common Muslims still believe that it is their right to own this area, Bengal, Bihar, and Odisha. And we have to fight against this. And this fight, only logical and academic fight, is not sufficient, because Muslims, as Manya Sudarshan ji said, that Musalman jo musal ko mante hai, o Musalman hote hai. We have to show the power of musal. This is, we understand.
Our friend. My name is Vaidyanathan, and I am the brother of Mr. Ramakrishnan ji. That's all. Now, I would like to ask you one question. You have problem in West Bengal. Similar problem exists in Kerala. The whole of this thing, the communists captured Kerala only with the help of Muslims and promising them great things in the future, which they allowed to happen. Even now, quite a number of legislators are elected from the Muslim dominated areas to the Kerala Assembly, and they dictate the terms in Kerala. So have you got any plans or any work going on in Kerala to resist this thing? Where the Hindus from 60 to 70%, they are now down to about 30%.
No, 48%. Now Kerala, I think this is figure that Hindu. 52%. See, at present the official status is 32% Muslim and 20% Christian. And rest 48% is Hindu. It is Kerala's official figure now. Actually, I am very much concerned about Kerala. Just last September, I visited Kerala, particularly North Kerala, for 10 days. I particularly visited Mallapuram because I was long interested about the 1923 Malabar riot, great Mopla riots. So I visited just last September. And I am very pained to see that in North Kerala, the situation is almost out of hand. There are three reasons. There was no everyday clash between Hindus and Muslims. Hindus are divided, particularly the fighting class Edwa. They are divided between Sangha and CPM. And one part murder, the other part retaliate. Both side, the killed and killers, both are Edwa Hindus. And Hindus, the fighting class, they are engaged among themselves, and Muslims are peacefully spreading their tentacles, their influence. In Kozhikode city, about 70% of business went out of hand of Hindus. It will be difficult for you to find a pure Hindu restaurant or Hindu hotel in Kozhikode city. And in Mallapuram, there are government registered conversion center in Ponyani. I visited that center. There, people come to be converted into Muslim, and 6 months to 2 years, they have to stay there, live there. There is a big mosque converted from a big temple, and by the side of that institution has been built. And there, Hindus come there, live there minimum for 6 months, get all type of trainings of Islamic rituals and Islamic history and Arabic culture, everything. And after that, he gets recognition that now he is a full Muslim. And these things go under a government registered organization. And I heard three institutions are there like this. And I visited all these areas, and I pained to see that in Kozhikode city, the Muslims in their family functions, like inauguration of building, huge money comes from Middle East. They invite the Hindus, and Hindus feel honored to get invitation from the Muslim houses. And excuse me, somehow I have a feeling that our Hindu leadership or Sangha leadership, we have fight against communists, our bitter enemy. No doubt communists are bitter enemy. But communism could not survive more than 70 years in any country. But Islam, they have subjugated us in many areas for 700 years. This is the difference between communism and Islam. So should we abandon the fight against Islam and engage fully ourselves to fight against communists, and that too against our own Hindu brothers? However, I have no specific suggestion for that. But in Kerala, the situation is this, that Hindus are fighting against Hindus. Hindus' numbers are dwindling. It became now below 50%. Therefore, Hindus are not, particularly the educated and wealthy Hindus, they are not in any mood to fight against Muslims. This is the reality. And if you go to Kozhikode beach, sea beach, you will see only Muslims, only burkhas. The situation is totally like any Middle East country if you go to Kozhikode sea beach. So, we are cautious that our fate should not be like Mallapuram. Even when I visited that conversion center, one Swayamsevak took me there. And that Swayamsevak bring his one Muslim friend. And that his Muslim friend helped me to visit the center in Ponyani.
Sir, I am Hello. My name is Devi Prasad. In your talk, you mentioned that some of the Hindu organizations in West Bengal, over three decades of communist rule, have gone out of their roots and have dilated their fundamental ideologies. Long time back, I heard that Ramakrishna Mission claimed that it is not a Hindu organization, right, but a separate sect.
Yeah.
Was it due to the infiltration of communists into the Ramakrishna Mission and because of the political pressure? Is my understanding is correct?
Actually, there are two reasons. One is the infiltration of secular element in Ramakrishna Mission. But there is another reason. The communist government, they control all the educational institutions. Actually, they control everything in their under their rule. And the due to our Article 31, 30A(1), the minority institutions get freedom, liberty to run their organization. Government cannot interfere in those organizations. The communist government, they are interfering, very disturbing the Ramakrishna Mission schools and colleges. And to protect their educational institutions from communist government interference, they pleaded that we are not Hindus, we are minorities, and we allow us to enjoy the Article 30A of the Indian Constitution. And it is peculiar that who maintained Ramakrishna Mission as Hindu organization, CPM fought against it in Calcutta High Court. And Calcutta High Court, West Bengal government won the case, and they allowed, yes, Ramakrishna Mission is a different religion, separate religion. Their religion is Ramakrishnaite. Therefore, they will be now minority and they will enjoy the Article 30 right. And then CPM government, they went to Supreme Court challenging Calcutta High Court's verdict. And in Supreme Court, CPM government won the case. And then only Ramakrishna Mission remained as Hindu. The credit goes to communist government to keep Ramakrishna Mission as Hindu organization. This is the paradox of history.
My friend spoke of humanism and secularism as vital for the political system, and found fault with our taking a religious stand with regard to Bengal. But I would like to remind our own people what happened to a great world power, Russia. In 1989, 13 Muslim states constituting their Soviet republics, all of a sudden, on one day, they declared themselves as independent states. Gorbachev could not prevent it. But how did it happen? For 3-4 years, Saudi Arabia had been sending 10 million copies of Quran to these 13 Islamic states constituting the Soviet Socialist Republic. The result was the Muslim nationalism took the advantage of it and all of a sudden decided to get separated as independent states from Russia. And Russia was powerless. It lost its great world power status. That is the experience of a non-religious political state called Russia. Another thing, China. How is China facing a problem? It's a non-religious communist state. The Uyghur province, which is on the border of Western China, it is a totally an Islamic part of China.
Xinjiang
they province. Have started demands for a separate state have started a movement to get separated from China. China is trying every method to suppress their nationalistic urge, the communal urge. They have banned the growing of beards by the Uyghur people. They have banned the wearing of parda by the women of Uyghur. Why should a non-religious political state, communist state, resort to this? The force of religion. It is the force of religion. We have not accepted our the force of our religion. In 1946, on June 2nd, Jinnah warned the country. Jinnah warned Mountbatten, Nehru. If you are not giving us partition, Muslims are prepared for a civil war. We are armed, united. We will wage a civil war. If you are partition, partition is not taking place now. That is the force of religion. Only thing we have failed to show the strength of our religion. We have been surrendering, compromising in the name of secularism.
We should have accepted that challenge of that civil war.
Any more questions? One more, sorry.
Sir, one thing I want clarification. Our constitution is a secular constitution, which means the government cannot take sides. It cannot be a theoretical state. Can we say India is a secular country? India is not a secular country. Constitution is a secular constitution. The government cannot favor one religion against another religion. Sir, people are saying that India is a secular country.
Don't interfere, sir. Please don't interfere. So is it correct to say
that our constitution is a secular constitution, which does not necessarily mean India is a secular country, because it is mostly religious.
In a secular constitution, there should not have been two wars, majority and minority. And since our secularism, our constitution have these two wars separately, therefore we cannot call it a pure secular constitution.
Just a minute. Yeah. I request you to go through a book called it's written by Conrad Elst. Okay, it's exclusively written about our constitution, where he has concluded it is negatively biased against Hindus. Negatively biased against Hindus. He has made a very detailed study. And kindly note, it is positively skewed in favor of minorities and negatively skewed against Hindus. It's a very clever way of drafting a constitution. And where the secular thing was added, that word.
Number two,
throughout the world, on the right side, you'll see Pakistan, which is a Muslim state. On the other side, you'll see Bangladesh, a Muslim state. Sri Lanka is a Buddhist state. Why can't Hindus have a Hindu state? Can you answer this question? No, I'm throwing this question open to all. I'm not expecting an answer from you. I'm not expecting an answer. Why can't Hindus have their own state? What prevents them from having? There are more than 100 Christian countries. America is a Baptist country. Please understand, you have to take oath on base of Baptist Bible. Donald Trump took his oath based on his own version of Bible. Please understand, his father belonged to a particular church, Mormon church, and he took oath on the Mormon Bible. Please understand. There are more than 80, 90 Muslim countries. Britain is an Anglican church. The Queen and the Anglican Bishop hates the Anglican church, and only an Anglican person can become a prime minister. Russia is headed by a Russian Orthodox church. Putin has to go there if he wants to get married, if he wants to get his dead buried. And no communist country can say that it is not religious. Religion has taken revivalism in Russia and in many other countries. Orthodox Christianity prevails in Greece and in Rome, it's Vatican Christianity. Unfortunately, many Indian Roman Catholics are calling themselves Roman Catholics. Where's the Roman passport? Why they are calling themselves Roman Catholics? Why not you question them? They still call themselves Roman Catholics. Archbishops carry two passports, Indian passport and Vatican passport. Which country will allow? Rayla College is having a Vatican radio from it. Why not some humanists go and investigate? How can you have a radio within Rayla College? Is it not a sovereign country? You have a foreign radio station in Laila College. Why not you go and protest? Why not you go and shout? Nobody does all these things. You keep on punching at Hindus, come to seminars and punch Hindus, go out and spread your venom. This is what is going on. And this is a deep state that is operating in India. It comes out like virus. In minus 200, 300 degrees, if you freeze, the virus will be there. This is a communist virus, Islamic virus, Christian virus, secular virus, humanist virus. It comes out everywhere and it keeps on popping at Hindus. This is a technical term. If you want to go through what is deep state, you can go through and so many websites are there, you can understand. They are going to do immense harm to Hindus. This is the only last civilization. If you go through that confessions of a Russian spy, he says this is the last state, last country with 6,000 years civilization. I didn't want to disturb it. We wanted to carry a massive massacre in Delhi in 1993. Our intellectuals, professors, everybody we wanted to massacre with the help of local communists. Somehow I was stopped from doing that because it's a very ancient civilization. I'll be doing a great injustice if I do that. Communism may be dead, but there are hundreds of communists in Chennai, in the newspapers, the magazines, Tamil TV channels, everywhere. They don't know anything about communism. They are in the intellectual institutions, they are in the think tanks, they write articles, and they write so many nasty things about us. We don't know how to identify them. They come in different forms, different shapes, and they present their views. And it's always against these two. They won't go and ask a Muslim this type of questions. Demographic, that Dr. A.P. Joshi is a very noble and senior person. He has written a very beautiful book on the demography of religious populations in India. It's a very well-drafted book, maybe 600, 700 pages. Kindly go through it. The communist publication never gave a book review for that book. Why do you buy the Hindu? I went to Kerala last week. Like what he did, and I was traveling for nearly 400, 600 kilometers. In that 450 kilometers, I counted 120 mosques. Small mosque, big mosque, hilltop mosque, roadside mosque, middle, in the middle of the hill, there's a mosque. In the bottom of the hill, there's a mosque. On a Friday, you cannot find a single hotel to have a vegetarian food. In the 450 kilometers, we could find only one hotel, Sri Sri Ravishankar's, somewhere calling itself Annapurna. The two, we had the lunch at around 5 o'clock in the evening. On the one side, kindly give me 2 minutes. On the one side, they destroy our history. They claim that Ayodhya has no history. On Kerala, they create an artificial history, spending 300 crores. I went for a book release function, and it's called Pattanam. That book, I gave to a few people here. Just a minute. I've written a book review. How 300 crores Hindu money has been utilized for an artificial Christian excavation to prove that Christianity came to India 1,000 years before Adi Shankara. And a huge body of Kerala Christians, huge body of academicia, with the help of communist rulers, are doing this work. On the one side, they destroy our history and claim deny that history. On the other side, in Kerala, they are creating artificial history. Kindly go through this communal agenda of Marxist and Christian historians in India. It's in the web. After I put this, they stopped shouting against Ayodhya. In Ayodhya, they deny our own existence. In Kerala, they create artificial history. And CAGS made some comments about the fraudulent excavation, and this person, professor, he has been removed from that post, I heard yesterday. Number two.
I'm happy you mentioned about this Christian missionaries' activities in India, which are much more dangerous than the Islamic fundamentalism.
This is a book that was written with the foremost Hindu archaeologist in Kerala, Dr. B.S. Harishankar, who has written this book after painstaking research. He was in Delhi and he was thrown out of Delhi by the JNU cartel, and he came to Kerala and settled down. He has published this book. Pattanam excavations, constructs, contents, and interventions. This is a book, and I have written it is a very technical book, but the book review is available in the internet, and you can go through it. Now we hand over to Shri Tapan Ghosh.
Any more questions?
Yeah. Hi, I'm Preetam. I'm from Kolkata only. I have a question like, hello, am I audible? Hi, I'm Preetam. I'm from Kolkata only. I have a question on Bangladeshi Hindus. Do you think they will exist for more than 20 years?
Very relevant question. Actually, just 1 hour before, I was discussing this with Gurumurti ji in his Tughlaq office. Bangladesh Hindus cannot survive in Bangladesh. Very simple. Their number very steadily and speedily dwindling. The only way for survival of Bangladesh Hindus is to Indian army has to enter in Bangladesh. There is no other way. Whatever we say, the every day, every night, Bangladesh Hindus are coming to India for their only self-protection, for their women's honor. There is no other way. The India has to make its mind that our army must enter into Bangladesh on whatever pretext they link. If America can cross the oceans for their own security and bomb on Iraq or other countries, so why we will not intervene in Bangladesh? Because our brothers and sisters are there. The pretext very easy, may be very easy to eliminate the anti-India elements in Bangladesh.